This is part two in our management product and pricing decisions or short-term business decisions series, and we're going to be talking about special orders. So special orders are one-time orders, and usually a reduced sales price is given on these special orders. There's a few things that management must think about when deciding whether or not to accept a special order. One of those is, does the company have excess capacity to fill this order? So if you do not have excess capacity and you're considering the order, that means you would have to reduce your current production level to accept the order. How is that going to affect your current business? Will the reduced sales price be high enough to cover the incremental cost of filling the order? So the reduced sales price that you're offering for this order, will that be enough to cover the increased cost of filling this order? And will the special order affect regular sales in the long run? So that goes back to the first bullet there we talked about. So if we have to reduce our current capacity to be able to fill this order, how will that affect the bottom line? So let's look at the decision rule. Should we accept or reject a special order? If your expected revenues exceed your expected increase in variable and fixed cost, then you should accept the special order. If your expected increase in revenues is less than your expected increase in variable and fixed cost, you should reject the special order. So let's take a look at an example here. Suppose the Baseball Hall of Fame in Cooperstown, New York, has approached sports cards with a special order. The Hall of Fame wishes to purchase 50,000 baseball card packs for a special promotional campaign and offers 37 cents per pack, a total of $18,500. Sports cards' total production cost is 57 cents per pack as follows. So we have our variable cost, direct materials are 14 cents per pack, direct labor is 7 cents per pack, and variable overhead is 11 cents per pack, and our fixed overhead is 25 cents per pack, for a total cost per pack of 57 cents. Sports Cards has enough excess capacity to handle the special order. Prepare an incremental analysis to determine whether Sports Cards should accept the special order. So an incremental analysis is where we want to take a look at the expected increase in revenues compared to the expected increase in expenses. And again, remember, deciding whether to accept or reject, we want to ensure that the expected increase in revenues is higher than the expected increase in expenses. So if we look at the expected increase in revenues, we know that's $18,500. We need to calculate our expected increase in expenses. So the variable cost is what's going to increase here. We're going to have 50,000 cards. That's going to cost us 32 cents per pack. The 32 cent is the variable cost. Our fixed cost per pack is not going to change. So that's not going to affect our decision here. So our expected change in operating income will be $2,500. Therefore, since the expected increase in revenues exceeds the expected increase in expenses, we would accept this special order.